With the decision made to set up camp for the night near the motorbike, Matt searches for a source of water to stave off dehydration, while Joe attempts to create a fire for signaling and hopefully water purification.
There's a lot of bamboo in here. I'm gonna check it for water, just because some areas it actually contains water in the joints. In this environment, every little task we do, we work up a sweat. We're losing a lot of water. So I cut down low on the nodule and I don't see any water right inside here. It's not looking good. It looks like there's some banana plants up there. Bamboo just wasn't quite cutting it. I'm gonna go check, see if I can get some water out of them. I saw a whole hillside covered in banana trees. So I'm thinking fruit, potentially water, two in one.
Southeast Asia is the native home of the banana palm, making them plentiful in this region.
This is great up here. This whole hillside's covered in bananas. So I'm gonna check it out right here. Oh yeah, look at this. So you can see the big bowl. This is where all the water is contained. So I'm gonna cut right above it, scoop out a little bit of moisture.
The trunk of the banana palm sits at ground level. And once cut down, the roots will continue to pump it full of water loaded with electrolytes, vital minerals that get lost with perspiration.
I'm actually getting sprayed with water. This is awesome. See all that moisture's already bubbling up. That's looking great already. Right now, I don't want to take out too much of the moisture with the knife, so I'm going to try to open up the hole with the stick. All that nice banana water right there. I'm going to let that settle up. It's already starting to accumulate quite a bit. Really nice. It's accumulating water, so I'm gonna have to still let it sit for a little bit, but hopefully in a half an hour I'll have a pretty good supply.
So I've collected some wood, I've made my little teepee, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna split this piece of bamboo and I'm gonna make some shavings off of this from my tinder bundle. For someone in this situation, the faster you can signal for rescue, the faster you're gonna get out of that situation. So right now, my priority is to get this fire built, throw some of those tires on her, get some smoke up in the air. So what I'm doing right now is I'm shaving this bamboo. The smaller you can make these, the better. What you really want are those curly Q things right there. That's what you want. These big pieces are fine, but the curly Qs is what you're looking for because it has more surface area and it'll catch a spark easier. And all I need is enough to make it from the bike over here to my teepee. So I think, you know, that'll probably do it right there. I've got more if I need it, but I think I'm good to go. There's a little bit of gas in the fuel filter. So what I'm thinking is if I can create that arc from the spark plug wire, that may be an ignition point to get us a fire going. Not a lot of gas in there, but it's gonna evaporate quickly. I've gotta work fast right now. Any of the gas that leaks out, I want it to leak out over my tinder. This cardboard piece is what I've been wanting. This is the first time I've done something like this, so there's no guarantees, but I really need this to work. Started this bike several times.
Come on, baby.
It's just not igniting the filter paper, and I don't know why. Oh. All right, I'm gonna let this start to burn. Once it gets cooking, I'm gonna throw on the tires and hopefully, you know, maybe somebody could see some black smoke.
A few hundred meters away, Matt has cut down a banana palm and removed the pulpy center to create a bowl that the roots have pumped full of nutrient-rich water.
You can see all that moisture in there moving around. Now that I've got this pocket accumulating water from the banana tree, I'm gonna go out and find a container so I can bring it back to Joe. I almost stumble into a venomous viper. It's hanging out right in the tree at eye level. Where I live, you gotta look for snakes on the ground. Out here, that thing can land right on your back. In Vietnam, 30,000 people get bit by snakes each year. You've gotta watch every step you take, and I'm gonna show it respect and leave it alone. So I'm probably not gonna tell Joe.
Let's see what kind of smoke this thing makes. This stuff's gonna burn for about 20 or 30 minutes. That means someone's gonna have to be looking in this direction, see the smoke, and then go investigate it. But you know what? If you don't try, you have nothing else to do but wait, and that doesn't work in my book. Now you're really starting to see that black smoke, and that's what I was looking for. And this is it. This is all we got. It's a long shot, but it's a shot you have to take in a situation like this.
All around this area is huge bamboo stands, so I'm gonna cut a section of this, and I'll have a water container. In a survival situation where timing is everything, I can't monkey around trying to figure out the clean way to get water out of here. So I'm gonna slurp it up with a straw, spit it out. Joe's gonna have to be happy with that. A little banana water and saliva never hurt anybody.
Using one of the motorcycle's foot pegs and a cotton rope that was tied to the back of the bike, Joe makes a tinder tube.
All right.
Heat from the coals will char the rope, producing easily ignitable tinder material.
Having char cloth is huge because all you need is a tiny, tiny spark off of a flint and a knife, poof, that'll light char cloth. So I'm gonna get that burning real well, blacken it up real good. And all I'm gonna do is just pull it inside the tube and it's gonna extinguish it. So wherever Matt and I go, as long as we can get a spark, we have a very easy way to start a fire. What's up, bro?
Oh, nice.
Took a little bit, but it worked. That's all that's left of the tires.
Tell me you have water in there.
I got some water.
Good deal.
There's a bunch of banana plants out on the hillside. I got some green bananas. They're not ripe, but we could travel with them for a bit.
Matt's got water and he's got some green bananas, which is great. That's huge calories that we could definitely use.
Where'd you get this?
Cut the banana plant down and got it from right at the base.
How did you get the water from inside the trunk inside the bamboo?
Basically, I just took a straw and sucked it up and spit it in. I didn't want
Thanks
to
for the water,
it
man. For you. That's a huge party foul, man. That's just not cool. All right.